Which of the angels did God ever say, sit now at my right hand till your enemies obey? They all shall be asunder.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning to everyone around the world.
Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. My name is Thommy Sides, and this is my good friend, Pastor Mlambo, and he's from Zimbabwe, and he also is a school teacher here in South Africa, teaching the South African kid, and also about God, I'm sure.
I'm doing that.
Hallelujah.
Definitely, I wouldn't miss the chance of saying out the message to the people of the world, even here where I've got the privilege of teaching.
Yes. And today we're going to talk to you a little bit about Joel. And the book of Joel is a prophetic book. He was a minor prophet in the Old Testament. And he said some very interesting things. His theme was basically the day of the Lord. And what he said was in chapter 3, verse 11, he says in the New Living Translation here, "Come quickly, all you nations everywhere, gather together in the valley." And that's later referred to as the Valley of Decision. There is a Valley of Decision. People are going to have to make, as in these final days, there's a book about the final days here, Joel, that they're in that valley, they got to make a decision for the Lord. Are you going to be for God, or are you going to be for the devil? And that's really what the word is. And just after that it says, "And now, O Lord, call out your warriors." And in the King James it says, "the mighty ones." Okay, so God's people have to arise. We have to stop thinking this mentality that we're just saved little Christians. Okay, we need to be warriors. Why do you think in Ephesians chapter 6 it says, "Put on the whole breastplate of armor." You know, your shield of faith, your breastplate of righteousness, your sword of the Spirit, your helmet of salvation. Your feet of the preparation of the gospel. Why? So that you can really do all things. And my brother, what do you have to say about all this?
Yeah, because here my Bible, my version is the Message Bible. It says, soldiers at attention. It's a battle cry. It's a war cry. It's like we have delayed so much as Christians. We have been going about as wimps, as people who are weak, people who have to be given some things and some doctrines to teach. Everything about our lives has been dictated by the dictates of the law or the prevailing economic and political situations, such as in my case at where I come from. But well, when God says arise, our warfare is not carnal, our warfare is mighty, our warfare is spiritual, and so we really have to come to attention and then do something about our lives as Christians. Both at home, at work, and wherever we gather as Christians, we have to do something about ourselves.
Amen. Amen. And I'm just in agreement with my dear brother. And I just thank God that God is raising up a new breed of leadership in the church. And Mr. Mlambo is just an example of that. And you just need to keep praying that God will keep doing this great work that he's doing in the last days, raising up new leadership. And just pray for yourself, too, that God will give you wisdom. You know, James 1:5 says, "If any man and any woman lacks wisdom, let him ask of God."
And then God will give that wisdom liberally, abundantly,
right,
without limit.
That's right, without limit. Hallelujah. And
as we are talking of that, you know, in most places, the seaside, like a beautiful place like this which God created, where we can actually worship and praise God, the satanic forces have made this and turned this into their own shrines.
That's right.
They gather in the dark of the night, they gather in every time of the day, and they do everything. But as the water is breaking forth in the serfs, it means we have to break forth, even in prayer, in warfare, spiritual warfare, in love. We should conquer the world through love.
Hallelujah, brother. Yeah. Let me hug you.
Thank you.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. You know, and that's the key, is 1 Corinthians chapter 13, the great love chapter that Paul wrote. You know, it says, "These three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Amen. Yes.
And then 1 John will go on in 1 John chapter 4. He will say, "Beloved, Let us love one another, for love is of God. He who does not love does not know God, for God is love.
Amen.
Yeah. And so we have to conquer the world through love. Actually, it's not conquering the world, it's actually inviting people back to where they belong. And that is to God, not to the world standards, not to the teachings of the world. Yes, we respect every authority which comes our way, but as we respect the ultimate authority is the authority of God.
Amen.
And we have had democracy, we have had all the crises, whatever you might call it, but we have got the rule by God, theocracy.
And you know, as far as that's concerned too, whenever a man-made law overtly contradicts one of God's laws, we as Christians should obey God's law.
Yes.
You know, we can't obey the, if laws go totally against what
God is saying, then it is not
like
the law.
Yeah, like the evil sin of abortion. Just because man has said, yeah, it's legal, you can do this evil act, kill your baby that's living inside you, we as Christians know that this is an evil act.
Because actually Leviticus will say life is in the blood.
Ooh.
And from the moment a child is conceived, from the very second, God has already ordained that particular child who is in the womb, who is in the blood. It's not an iota, it's not a part of an experiment which can be taken care of by the world, by the decisions of the world, by the pro-abortionist and everyone who is like-minded. It is the life of God. Like he said, before I even knew you, before your mother knew you, I knew you. I foreordained you as a prophet. That's to the prophet Jeremiah.
Amen. Yeah, so what we're talking about here is that God wants his people to be warriors. You know, what did Jesus do right before he went to the cross? Right before that time, he said, I think it was at the end of the Last Supper, wasn't it? He says, is there a sword with us? And he said, well, yes, Lord, there's a couple swords here. And he says, that is enough. Because the Bible says in the Old Testament, Jesus will be numbered among the transgressors. In other words, among those that will fight against the system. But when Peter took that sword in his hand in the Garden of Gethsemane and he cut the high priest's servant's ear off, Jesus immediately picked that ear off the ground and put it back. By supernatural ability, Jesus infused that ear back into the man's head to show his great healing. But what the whole thing is, Peter wasn't just the wimp that denied Jesus three times. He was also, you know, and that's our, we as Christians do that, don't we? We're like gung-ho one day for God. We've got a sword in our hand.
And then the next day,
we're going to cut the devil's ear off.
And then we...
And then the next day, what do we...
We have lost him. Yeah. We have lost him. And because of all those things, the world looks at the Christians and believes that the Christians are weak people.
Right.
They are not successful people. They are there for begging. But our God does not beg. He owns the whole universe. He owns everything that is in it. To him, all these things are who is who in the greatest books of who is very rich, who is very successful. God does not measure success in the way the world measures success. And because of that, in this book which we have just read, the prophet Joel, he is a minor prophet not because he was small, he was minor because he said a very short and concise
Amen.
Word. But he was one of the greatest. What he says here in the Message translation, verse 17 of the second chapter, he will say, then you will know for sure that in my God, in your God, living in Zion, my sacred mountain, Jerusalem will be a sacred city. There is a need of sacredness. There is a need of holiness. There is a call that if we have to serve God, we have to do that in a sacred way. And then he will say, in that particular city, there shall be posted, there shall be a post reading, no trespassers. No trespassing.
Ooh, hallelujah.
So the church has to rise up and say, no trespasses.
Yeah.
No trespasses in our country. No trespassing in Africa. No trespassing in South Africa. No trespassing in Zimbabwe in our schools as teachers.
Yes.
Because there are a lot of people who are bringing a lot of teachings, a lot of doctrines, which are actually amounting to trespassing.
And even in the church, we have a lot of this.
Yes, and they will say, dress this way, this is legalism, this is holiness. It's like the word of God is now like an a la carte menu where you have to choose. It's like a supermarket. But yeah. It's not
like
that.
If you want
that.
Your blessing, just send us a $20 donation and you can get that new pool you want or something. You know, they trivialize God's word. God's word, my friends, is holy.
And you can't buy it for $20.
No, or $45 or whatever.
Or even $1 million or $1 billion. You can't buy the word of God.
Yes.
And the church cannot have
buy God's blessings either.
Yeah.
You know how you get God's blessings? By doing right. The Bible says, in James, in the last couple of verses of chapter 1, it says, true religion is this, to look after orphans and widows in their distress, and to keep oneself from being polluted by the world. We could symbolically say that's why you get into the baptism and you're submerged. You go into the water and you become clean in Jesus. God wants the church to be clean, to be a beautiful bride, so that He's coming back again soon.
And for a spotless bride.
Yes, Jesus wants to come back. When He comes back, He wants to see a bride that's beautiful. But you know what Jesus said right before He left? He said He was sad. Sometimes Jesus got sad too. And He said, when the Son of Man comes again, will He find faith on the earth? That's the main thing. When He looks into your life, He doesn't look at your bank account, how good looking you are, what your skin color is, friends. He looks at your faith. Hallelujah.
And how
that's
you
the
live,
word
yes.
for you. Your faith.
Your faith and how you conduct yourself, how you live on this time, and how prepared you are. Remember, He is coming for a spotless bride. And that spotless bride, you have got to do something about your life. You have to give yourself to Jesus. You have to start living.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
Today is the day of salvation. Today is we're in the valley of decision. This earth is almost, you could say, like a valley. While we live here in this earth, we are walking through this valley because things don't always work out, right? We go up, we go down. But you know what? It's a decision. We need to make a decision for Jesus, because one day God is going to call His warriors and His church.
Yeah, amen.
And
amen.
Hallelujah. It's going to be a wonderful time. Amen.
Yes. And people will come from every nation.
Every nation.
We just have to pray. We have to pray for ourselves. We have to pray for you at home, everyone who is watching this. We just have to pray, because this is how we communicate with our God. So let's agree. You can join us in prayer even this very moment.
Hallelujah. Let's hold hands, brother. Hallelujah. Lord Jesus.
Yes.
We just come together as a church, Lord. Black and white, yellow, Chinese, American Indian, or
every
our red.
Nation.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Every nation, because your word says in Joel, you're calling out a righteous people from every nation.
Amen.
And I just pray, Lord God, your Holy Spirit will move, that
yes.
you'll take out prejudice, you'll take out
in
bitterness from
Jesus.
Your church, Lord. Your church
Jesus.
Needs a divine healing. Your
yes.
church needs a divine cleansing.
Amen.
And I pray, Lord God, you'll give us a new heart. David, King David said, create in me, Lord, a new heart,
a
heart of flesh.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Where you can write your laws, where you can write your statutes, where you can mold it and shape it the way you want it to be. Thank you, Father, that we are not only passive participants in what we are doing, but we are making decisions and we are active. And every brother and sister who is at home, who is making a decision, empower them this very moment. Make them make right decisions for the future generations which shall come after us, in Jesus' name.
And also, we just come against, as warriors of Jesus Christ,
yes.
we come against every demonic force of hell.
In the name of
every
Jesus.
Demonic force that's trying to take over America, the great nation that God has blessed. Let thy grace shed on thee. Well, God's having to shed a lot of grace today on that land, but the Bible says, and this is the hope that Christians have there, that where wickedness abounds, there
grace
much more
abounds.
And that's the same way in your country, isn't it, brother?
Yes, we have seen the grace. Father, thank you even for Zimbabwe right now.
Yes.
For every man and woman who has stood even during the great turmoil, the economic meltdown. thank you that healing is coming, even reconciliation between the different political parties, the different leaders, that, my Father, we are given to you as a nation, that, my Father, your grace, we have seen it. We have seen the miracles. We have seen that, my Father, from hyper-inflationary levels, Father, that overnight all that inflation was gone. It is only Jesus Christ who did that for our country. Thank you for continuing with your healing upon our nation.
Hallelujah. And I pray a blessing over all the expatriates that have left Zimbabwe. You know, God bless you. We understand what happened. But, you know, pray and ask the Lord. Maybe God might want to bring you back. You know, because you are Zimbabwean. Hallelujah. Whether you're white or black or whatever, you're a Zimbabwean, and God might want to just bring you back. God brought me here to South Africa. I'm an American. I'm living here in South Africa, and I love it. God brought me here to do a work. And wherever you are, whatever country you're living in, God has a message and a work for you. And ask Him.
Yes.
Ask
Him.
Yes, yes. Hallelujah. We love you. God bless you.
God bless you.
And pray for us, please.
March on, my soul, be strong. March on, my soul. March on, my soul, be strong. March on, my soul. The kings came, they fought by the waters of Megiddo. March on, my soul, be strong. But they carried off no silver, they carried off no gold, they carried off no plunder, Lord. That's how the story's told.